chapter 41. We are going to read the Bible and tell you what it's about. Because this is our heritage.
Isaiah 41. Keep silence before me.
No, Isaiah 41. Verse. Start at 4. No, what? Start at Isaiah 44. Yeah. Slakia, 44. Slakia. Isaiah 44.
This is Isaiah 44, verse 1. Yet, now hear, O Jacob, my servant.
So we are Jacob. You hear about the 12 tribes of Israel? So Jacob are the progenitor of the 12 boys, 12 children. Read.
And Israel, whom I have chosen.
So we are the children of Israel. The Lord chose us, especially. Where your father from?
Jamaica and Barbados.
You are Israelite. My birth, blood. Read.
Thus says the Lord that made thee and formed thee from the womb, which will help thee. Fear not, O Jacob, my servant, and thou, Jeshurun, whom I have chosen.
So we are the chosen of the Heavenly Father. And the Heavenly Father's name is Yahawah.
That's right.
That's Hebrew. And his son, who the ignorant call Jesus Christ, Yahawashi. Right? Something happened to we in our life, sister. You ever read this here? Get me the book of, what a scripture. Get me the book of, we were sold to the nation, not for destruction. No, not that. Give me the book of, Esther 7:4. Esther 7:4. Now, Bible. This happened to his sister. We are reading this to you, and why you get the understanding? Because this Bible is our heritage.
Esther 7:4. For we are sold. I and my people to be destroyed.
So which people mean soul? Right. Uh-huh. They're not black people. That's the terminology where they put upon us, black people. But we are the children of Israel. Right? So we, the children of Israel, were sold to be what? Destroyed. Even right now, we are still just destroyed, sister. Because, as I just said, black people. Right? Yeah. And destroyed people said them word there. If you ask an African where he come from, mm-hmm. where more tell us? If I give Nigeria, I give what Togo, I give somewhere where he knows about, yo, I'm my landmaster.
Yeah.
But me and you, we black. You understand? Because we destroy. Right? Read on. No, that's it on that. Give me the book of King Songs of Solomon chapter 1, verse 5. But listen, sister. This terminology where they call black,
Solomon.
It still, you know, represent us. Because what? We have melanin. So true, we have melanin, then so we're black. Yeah. But we are going to show you something. Songs of Solomon.
Songs of Solomon, 1 verse 5.
You know anything about the Bible?
Here and there.
Right, so who was Solomon's father? Right.
Songs of Solomon, 1 verse 5. I am black.
What did Lord
say? I am black.
So Solomon was a so-called black man. Read.
But comely.
But him beautiful. Read.
O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar,
so him
as
said,
the curtains of Solomon.
He said, daughters of Jerusalem, I talk about him next to king. You daughters of Jerusalem. Solomon said, look for me. You're some black and comely and nice. I want to be like. And that Solomon is saying, right? Now give me Job 30 verse 30. We are going to show you, sister. So this book, I talk about us. Give me Jeremiah 8 verse 21.
My skin is black upon me.
This is Job, you know. Did you know that in the Bible? Read.
And my bones are burnt with heat.
None of these pastors are not carrying out the real words of the scripture.
That's right.
They give it the people in the church feel good factor.
Feel good factor.
So them can throw more money. And said, come up for your offering, right? And the, what they call it special prayer. And then when you get special prayer, you got to throw one bigger money in the bowl where them have. We don't want a bowl. No, we don't want a bowl because the Lord said, freely get it, freely give it. Proverbs 23. Read it out.
This is Jeremiah chapter 8 and verse 21. for the hurt of the daughter of my people. I am hurt. I am black.
What Jeremiah said?
I am black.
Jeremiah was a black man too. So this book is our history book system. Nobody can come squeeze up and go on and say them have some, you know? Nothing to do with this book. Our book. Now give me the book of Acts chapter 10 verse 36.
Jeremiah 14 verse 2. Judah mourneth the gate and the gates thereof languish.
So it said the Jew. Because Jews that Judah, that are one our tribe. Right. So Judah, it said the Jew stand for Judah. Right? So it said Judah. Read that mourning. Again.
Judah mourneth.
So the Jews are in mourning. So we, the original Jew of the scripture, are in mourning. And what?
And the gates thereof languish.
So the gate will for protect us. There's no protection. The language is open. So anybody can do us anything. You see? When they're looking at America and a brother driving car and the police pull him over, what happened to him? Normally, he might go for all him driver's license and them shoot him. So there's no protection. The gate are languish. They are what?
They are black unto the ground.
They are what?
They are black unto the ground.
So you see the whole of the Bible, this is black history. But they won't tell you that.
That's right.
They might come tell you about slavery and all kind of foolishness. Jeez. Right? But slavery was a punishment unto us. Because we break the commandments of the Heavenly Father. And that's why that happened. Now we are going to show you, sir, we don't want no money from nobody. Proverbs 23.
This is book of Proverbs chapter 23 and verse 23. Buy the truth and sell it not.
So all we buy the truth, we invest our little time. We sit down and we study and go through. And we call the brother and say, brother, you know what, sir, it said this. And brother say, yeah, come on. And him send back a precept.
That means yes.
Right. So we sit down and we study. That's how we buy the truth and we now sell it. Right? That's better.
Also, wisdom and instructions.
Wisdom and instructions. This is what the Bible gave us.
And understanding.
And understanding. Right? So give it through that precept.
Wait, so let me ask you a question. Yeah. Are they not in churches? Are they not reading from this Bible? Is it a different Bible?
No, they have the same Bible, but I'm going to show you what I read. Give me John 3:16. I'm going to show you what they read. Right? Okay. But them not get the understanding from it neither. Because, see, them understanding is trickery. Now, I'm going to ask you a question. Who give these pastor license to be a pastor?
God knows. That's what I'm saying.
God knows, right? Because it's what happened, sister. Basically, all of these pastors, they have to go to a school. When they go to the school, they declare them as pass. So when them pass, them get a service ticket. And that service ticket, them certify to tell lie. So the lie where them certify to tell is to keep this organization going. Because everything built up on lies, sister. Mm-hmm. You're calling yourself a black woman, that's a lie. You understand? With people them out here, you know, working for other people. People should be working for us.
That's right.
But we never know all these things. But now the Lord give us the understanding. But she just asked, read this.
This is Jeremiah 23 verse 1. Woe be unto the pastors.
What the Lord said?
Woe be unto the pastors.
The Lord said, destruction. Woe mean destruction unto these pastors. What them do?
That destroy and scatter the sheep of my pastors.
Then destroy the children of Israel and do not show them the right way. They don't know it either.
Sorry, where are you reading from? What is it?
Jeremiah 23. They don't know it either. Now jump to 28. No, my word, fire.
23 verse 29. Is not my word like as a fire?
So the Lord said, the pastor will bring out his word. It's supposed to have like a fire.
Says the Lord.
Burn people, read.
Says the Lord, and like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces.
The pastor now come out with that. He might come with one smooth gospel where the Heavenly Father said, he prophesied now Isaiah. Give me Isaiah chapter 20, 30 and start at smooth things. I believe 9. Isaiah 30 and 9, somewhere up there, where they want smooth things.
Amen.
Because the Father prophesied all things. You have it?
Isaiah.
Yeah. Read
30.
You find it.
This is the book of Psalms 119 and verse 104. Through thy precept I get understanding. Therefore I hate every false way.
So the Lord said, through the precept we get understanding. So you can't read the Bible like a novel. You're going to get carried away. You're not going to understand what you're reading. Give me Isaiah chapter. Let me show you how you read the Bible. Give me Isaiah 28 verse 9. Read this.
Isaiah 30 verse 9. Slakia verse 10. Which say to the seers, see not, and the prophets prophesy not unto us right things.
And that's why they mean in the Christian church. They say, prophesy not unto us right things. Prophesy what?
Speak unto us smooth things.
So smooth things is like God love everybody. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. We're going to bring up John 3:16 to you and show you what John 3:16 means. Right. You understand? Because the people do not have the understanding. Get me John 3:16. Read it, preacher.
This is the book of Malachi, chapter 2 and verse 7. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
What did Lord say?
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
The priest is supposed to keep knowledge and tell you what the Lord says, not what man teach him to say. The Lord said, give me Jeremiah 17 and 5.
And they should seek the law at his mouth.
And we have to seek the law of the priest's mouth, because I am a teach knowledge. Read.
For he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts.
And what say? The priest supposed to be the messenger of the Lord of hosts. Jeremiah 3 and start at 14, 15. Read where you are.
Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 5. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and make his flesh his arm.
So the Lord said, cursed be the man that put his trust in man, and make man flesh his arm. That means man's flesh is strength. Read. That's it, and that. Read where you are, sir. John 3 verse 16.
Uh-huh. For God so loved the world.
For God so what?
So loved the world.
For God so loved the world. No, we're going to lead with the word world. Right? And so you say, what do you think of world? There's more than one word. Right? Now give me the book of Hebrew chapter 1 and start at 2. And you know more. Isaiah 45, 17. Acts chapter 2 verse 21. Now read where you have Hebrew.
This is Hebrews chapter 1 and
verse 2. I need the word. Hold on, John 3:16 said later.
Have in these last days spoken unto us by his son.
So this is Jesus, who the world is going to call Jesus, whose name is Yahawashi. Would just mean he come to deliver. Read.
Whom he have appointed heir of all things.
He appointed him heir of all things. Read.
By whom also he have made the world.
By him. The Lord made the worlds. Read. Spell the words there. Make you understand it.
W-O-R-L-D-S.
So that means what? Plural. World. More than one world.
Yeah.
Right? Because you have rich world, poor world, animal world, all different kind of world. Right? Now we are going to deal with it. Read John 3:16 again.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Mm-hmm.
That whosoever believeth in him.
So we are going to deal with the whosoever now. Right? Now give me Acts.
Acts 2.
Mm-hmm. And start at 21.
Acts 2 verse 21. And it came to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall
whosoever
be saved.
Read.
Ye men of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Hear these words.
So these are the whosoever talking about. Ye men of Israel. Hear these words. Now give me the world now. Read back John 3:16 again.
John 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
So we are dealing with world now. Read this.
This is the book of Isaiah chapter 45 and verse 17. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
So Israel are going to save in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Read.
Ye shall not be ashamed, nor confounded, world without end.
What?
World without end.
Oh, so the world's not coming to an end?
Israel is a world without end. So this world coming to an end, but Israel gonna be a world without end. Give me that in a
How do I go there?
No, this is how you go there.
I want to go there. I want to go there. I want to go there. I don't want to be gay. No, I want to go there.
No, we're going to share the world without end. Daniel, chapter 7, and start at 18.
I just want to know, overground, west, underground, west. How do I get there?
No, here we're going to show you. Here we're going to show you.
Okay.
And give me Revelation 12, 21, verse.
That's where I come from, isn't it?
Daniel.
Daniel 7, verse 18.
So this is the world without end.
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
This kingdom coming to an end, and we are going to take it. Kingdom does mean dominion.
Yeah.
We are going to have dominion over the whole earth. Read.
And possesses the kingdom forever.
And we are going to possess the kingdom forever.
Even forever and
even
ever.
Forever. We're not coming back out of power.
That's right.
You understand? So this is the world without end.
We're not in power right now.
No, the Edomites are in power. Give me Job 9:24. We're going to show you everything.
We're going to show you
Job 9:24.
Job 9:24. The earth is given into the hands of the wicked.
So the Lord gave the earth into the hands of the wicked. Read.
He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
So the Heavenly Father gave the earth into the hands of the wicked, because this is a wicked time to rule. And that's why everything where you see happen, you have to know says a wicked time to rule. Right? So who are ruling the earth?
Can I say it out loud?
Yeah, you cannot say it.
A certain community of people.
You see them there? They are the ruler of the earth. Them can call and tell anybody, say, you have to make sure LBGQQ, whatever,
yeah.
And you have to make them live. Yeah. Right? But the Bible goes against that.
But apparently, because God loves everyone, God loves those people as well. Is that
no, it doesn't case? Say that in the Bible. Okay. No, get me the book of Proverbs, chapter 16,
but
verse 4.
We have priests that are.
Huh?
Part of that community.
Say that again.
We have like people who are priests who are also part of that community. How does that?
They are not in this community of the Lord. They're
okay.
In them own portfolio. Them in the Lord Aquarium. Right? Read that.
Proverbs 16, verse 4. The Lord has made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the days of evil.
So you see, he make everybody for himself. He make the animal, he make the birds for himself. Yeah, even the wicked for the day of evil.
Right.
So now, as we explained, we are living in an evil time. So after them time for rule. Because the Lord want evil to do what? Ramp up in the world.
Right.
Because he are the one who are going to bring down the rukus.
Right.
You remember what happened in Turkey?
Yeah.
Everybody was having fun. And then the Lord shook. And everybody popped down. I saw the Lord work, sister. So we are showing you right now, this is how we know we know. Isaiah 28 and start at 9 months. Eh? Yeah. Isaiah, I'm going to show you how you read the Bible. Precept must be upon precept.
Chapter 28 and verse 9. Whom shall he teach knowledge, and whom shall he make to understand doctrine?
So the Lord said, who am I going to teach knowledge and who are going to understand doctrine? Read.
Them that are weaned from the milk.
So you see, them that are weaned from the milk. You don't get no children. No, when a child born, he must be weaned from the milk.
Yeah.
Before he get teeth, right?
Yeah.
Read.
And drawn from the breast.
Mm-hmm.
For precept must be upon precept.
What did the Lord say?
Precept upon precept.
So you see how we read one part of something and we go over another book. That's precept upon precept. Read.
Line upon line,
read.
Line upon line,
uh-huh.
Here a little and there a little, uh-huh. With stammering lips and another tongue will he speak to this people.
That's all you have to deal in the Bible. You get a little precept, yes, sir. You go around and say you get the next precept and you match it up. That's all the Heavenly Father said. Who shall he teach knowledge? We have to do what? Learn. We have to do what? Put in our time, man. Give me that now. Second, Timothy chapter 3, verse 15 or 16. Where them?
This is book of Malachi, chapter 1 and verse 1. The burden of the word of the Lord of Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet you say, wherein as dost love us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother?
So, say Esau the Lord. Is the so-called white man. Iman Jacob come from the same womb. Read.
Saith forsake the Lord, yet I love Jacob, and I hated Esau.
So the Lord loved our forefather, and he ate for them forefather. Read.
And laid his mountain and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness.
And laid everything waste to them. But look how the Lord lift them up and put them in their authority right now. That's the power of the Lord, man. Because what? The Heavenly Father said, through injury. Give me the book of Sirach chapter 10, verse 11. Sirach 10 and 11.
I got to go after.
Yes, darling. Sirach chapter 10, verse 11.
This is Sirach chapter 10 and verse 11. For when a man is dead, he shall...
No, we don't want that. We want Sirach chapter 10 and start at... start at 7.
It's Sirach chapter 10 and verse 7.
Start at 8.
Verse 8. Because of my righteous dealings, injuries and riches got by the sea.
Because of unrighteous dealing. These people, them deal unrighteous. Injury get by the sea. Them deceit the whole world right now. And tell us, say you're a black woman, when you're a daughter of Zion, the best woman upon the earth. So we have been deceived. Them call me black man, when me are an Israelite man.
Right.
The most valiant man will stand up in our earth. Read.
Kingdoms. The kingdom is translated from one people to another.
So the kingdom translated, and the Lord do this, translate the kingdom from one people to another, man. Right? So sister, when we get out of the show, you say you're a daughter of Zion. And you are one of the most precious women walking the earth. You have to come back to your God, your nationality, your book. No PhD, no better than this. Because this is the truth. And this is what's going to make you free. Read.
This is 1 Timothy 2 verse 9. In like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
You know what is modest apparel? So look how sister dress. You can't see sister bum. You understand? You can't see sister top. Because she modest. Read.
With shamefacedness and sobriety.
So shamefacedness meaning you have to have a humble spirit. You can't walk and look up in a man's face. Unless I hear a man. You understand? Read.
Not with boarded hair or gold or pearls or costly array.
So the Lord said, you know, but I go and like say you want to come out here and put yourself up in a fashion. You look good in a people's eyes. You have to humble. That's a beautiful daughter of Zion. That's who the Lord works with, a humble spirit, in love. Read.
But which becometh woman professing godliness with good works.
With good works. And that's the way I said to your sister, your daughter of Zion, the Heavenly Father, said woman of a wear chosen. So we have to change our apparel and start to wear things where the Heavenly Father ordained us to do. And I saw you're going to go come into the kingdom. We could get the kingdom before she go. In Revelation chapter 21, verse 11, verse 12.
Revelation 21, verse 12. And had a wall great and high, and had 12 gates, and at the gates, 12 angels.
So 12 angels are the 12 doors, because 12 tribes of Israel, this kingdom is for. Read.
And names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
And this is the name written of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. So the children of Israel, you have 12 tribes of Israel, where them names are going to do engraft upon all of these gates. So Benjamin going through the Benjamin gate. And with beautiful sister right here, she's a Benjamite. So she will come to our gate. Yes. Lord willing, we see her in our kingdom, man.
That's right.
Right? And she can say, hey, remember me? Right?
That's
and she
right.
Take heed. And we have to know her, humble, and know some boy. Obedience is the key. Right? You have something?
Do you always cover your hair as well?
Yeah.
This is Ephesians.
When she say it. You have to airdrop. Bro, Islam take away our custom system. Because do you, if you notice all the daughters Islam, all them dress modest, your custom them take away. You understand?
Yeah, I believe in that.
Right. And then our people them now start hang out them bum. Right? And a sin we gone in.
So this is the one question that you ask. You want to get to where you want to get to?
Yeah.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 19 and verse 16.
Read out.
And behold, one came and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And he said unto him,
This is Christ that speak.
And he said unto him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
So this is how you are going to enter into life, sister. Keep the commandment of the Heavenly Father. But you see, we don't give you no commandment. But I will tell us a woman of a weird. So that's a one commandment.
Oh.
And
But don't kill.
No, that is 10 commandments. But there are 613 commandments we get. But hear my sister. You know the most important one? Love your neighbors as yourself. And who is your neighbor? Get me Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. This is the most important
one. My little neighbor, my community.
Just from the church.
Your neighbor, your neighbor represents your daughter, children of Israel. Read.
This is the book of Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him.
So when it's a rebuke, if you see your sister do something wrong, pull her up. You can't do that. Girl, come out of them trousers then. Because the Lord said we're not supposed to get in our trousers. If she rebel and no one say, the Lord said, leave her to her own. You understand? But you give her the message. Right? Read.
Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
So if your sister or your brother do you something, don't carry no grudge. Talk to them and, you know, make it dead. Don't carry on. Because these are the things where we are going to do. Always at loggerhead with each other. Read.
But thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself, I am the Lord.
Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. So make sure you know who is the neighbor. Shulakia, we never bring out the part there. Read your thing again.
This is the book of Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 18. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
Bless the children of
thy people,
the world.
That is your neighbor.
Welcome to the children.
Possessive pronouns. So this is not our
children,
neighbor.
Children, welcome
this
to the world.
This is one of them outcasts. When we work and plan to feel.
You have to welcome to
you understand?
The
that's their duty.
Your
you never know. Give me the book of Leviticus. Leviticus chapter 25 and start at 44, I believe. Leviticus 25, 44. This is what the Lord say you have to do. Daughter Zion.
It's the book of
25, 44.
It's the book of Leviticus chapter 25 and verse 44. Both thy bondmen and thy bondmaids, which thou shalt have, shall be of the heathen.
That's a heathen. Mm-hmm. So now, if you have bondman and bondwoman, that means slave people. If you have them, and them have we now, because we break the commandment. Read.
That are round about you, of them shall he buy bondmen and bondmaids.
We can buy bondman and bondmaid from them. Say, if sister have some, you call sister and say, more than a dozen. Sister say, yeah, man, you have them, come. Your money, right? That's it, that. Right. We have.
2 Ezra 6 and 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all. And the people also, whom thou hast chosen.
So Ezra said, we all come from Adam, and the people who thou hast chosen, thou mean the Heavenly Father chose. Read. And we are the Israelites. Read.
All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
This world was made because of us, the Israelites' sake. Read.
As for the other people.
As for the who?
As for the other people.
So he's talking about the next people, the heathen. Read.
Which also come of Adam. Thou hast said that they are nothing.
What did the Lord say?
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
They are nothing, but why are they?
But be like unto spittle.
You know what is spittle? You attack a little spittle there, but that's the equivalent of them. Read.
And as like the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
So me have to go water like that and a little drop out like that.
Yes.
That's them again.
Read.
And now, O Lord, behold these heathen.
These who?
These heathen.
No, them are rule over we. Ezra said, no, Lord, these heathen.
Read. Which has ever been reputed as nothing, has begun to be lords over us.
No, because,
and devour us.
Because we break the commandment of the Lord, curse the power. Deuteronomy chapter 28. Right, sister. Deuteronomy 28, verse 15.
That's
this is
right.
Our punishment.
But we, thy people.
How do you repent? Like, how do
no,
you
this is how we are going to repent.
No, listen now.
Yeah. Give me Psalm chapter 35. I'll start at 5. Psalm chapter 35. I'll start at 5. And give me the book of Second Ezra. Give me Sirach chapter 21 and start at 1.
Sing the year for purpose.
Yeah, 35:5?
Yeah. It's Psalm chapter 32 verse 5.
He said he's going to take one from family.
And give me the book of this. Ecclesiastic 21 verse.
Remove that one from your
family. This is the book of Psalm chapter 32 and verse 5. I acknowledge my sin unto thee.
So we have to acknowledge our sin unto the Lord. Read.
And my iniquity have I not hid.
What the Lord said?
And my iniquity have I not hid.
Read.
I said I will confess my transgression unto the Lord.
What the Lord said?
I said I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord.
So we say we are going, you know, reveal our transgression unto the Heavenly Father. We are going to break for pardon. Read.
And thou forgavest the iniquity of my sin.
And the Lord will forgive us the iniquity of our sin.
For this shall every one that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found.
Right.
Surely in the floods of
the Father. So we have to pray to the Heavenly Father to forgive us of our sin. This is all we are going to repent. Right, give me Acts chapter 17 and start at 30. Read where you are.
Ecclesiasticus 20, 21 and verse 1. My son, hast thou sinned? Do so no more.
My son and my daughter, your sin, do so no more. Read.
But ask pardon for thy former sin.
Ask pardon for your former sin. Tell the father, say, you're not going to put on the more choices. You're going to put on the right attire. You're going to start, you know, do the right thing where you're supposed to do, so the Heavenly Father can have mercy upon you.
No.
Hippo?
Now and again, but I try not to.
Oh.
Yeah. You're not supposed to, are you?
No, that's another thing, sister. Right?
No, honestly, I don't really touch it.
I'm not supposed to eat meat.
I know you're not supposed to eat meat,
but
it makes me feel sick when I eat it.
Oh, you see? Sick. That's a spiritual thing.
I'm telling you.
The Lord reject it out there, but
yeah.
Right? And no fight time, you know, the Lord do certain things, but we refuse to, you know, take heed.
Yeah.
But you, we don't know. But now you get revelation. Walk on. Read on.
Flee from sin.
What the Lord say?
Flee from sin.
The Lord say, flee from sin.
As from the face of a serpent.
So if you see a serpent, you not go near him. So the Lord say, flee from sin as the face of a serpent. So the Lord compare sin to a serpent. You are going to get bite from a serpent. So if you keep on eat these things, you are going to get bite by the Heavenly Father.
For if thou comest too near it,
okay,
it will bite thee.
Right.
The teeth thereof are as the teeth of a lion.
Right. So we don't want no lion bite
with. Of men.
We don't want a lion bite with, and we don't want a serpent sting with. So yo, we have to make sure, sir, we do what the Father ordained us to do, so we can stay in the right path with the Father. Read where.
Leviticus 11 and verse 7.
Mm-hmm.
And the swine.
The swine, we know what the swine means, the pig.
So he divide the hoof and be cloven footed.
Uh-huh.
Yet he chew it, not the cud.
Read.
He is unclean to you.
He's what?
He is unclean to you.
The pig is unclean unto us. Read.
Of your flesh.
Hold on, what are you saying?
Isn't it actually possible to live in this world and abide by 630 something?
You and our sister,
that's
what we are trying to show you, sir. Love thy neighbor, as thyself. That class for 100 commandments.
Is it?
Yes.
give me another six.
So basically,
that's a cheat code.
If you love your neighbor as you love yourself, you now suffer sin from them. You understand? And the next important one, the first and most important one, love the Lord thy God with all of your heart and your mind and your soul. That's another 100, sister. You understand? So if you cover them two there, you cover one big portion. You understand? So now, what we are going to try to show you again, we give the dietary law, so you can't eat certain things.
Yeah.
We give the clothes law, so you can't wear certain things.
Yeah.
And we give you the, what else we give out? We give, bring out the tattoo as well.
And the Sabbath.
Tattoos.
And the Sabbath.
What is
the Sabbath now, we are going to give you the Sabbath as well.
I've got tattoos, but I don't get them no more. That's why it's every penny.
What about?
Yes. You can wear that, you get that.
Yeah.
In the Levitic.
And you can. Really?
In the book of Ezekiel.
Can you paint your hands?
Him tell us you can't do those things. You understand? As a woman, you know, womanish.
And at home, you take off your hands off, right?
Yeah.
And the thing is this now, sister. When you're menstruating, basically, yes, sister.
I get a ticket, sir. You're paying for it.
Oh, yeah, no. Where you care about? Oh. Okay. The thing is this now, sister. When you're on your menstruation, right?
Yeah.
You can't really come around brothers. You understand? You have to separate yourself. You understand? But the thing is this. No, you see, with your husband now, basically, the way they build them place are with me now. We don't have the big room where we can separate.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? So, Lord willing, you know what's right.
But you don't sleep in the same bed as your husband. You don't sleep in the same bed if you're
me not. Right? But if you don't have the whole upper room, you can't do it.
Oh, okay,
you have to know somebody.
What about, do you still pray? Can you still touch the Bible?
No. You leave the Bible alone.
You don't pray during this time?
Yeah, you can pray, but you just leave the Bible. You understand? Because you're unclean. You understand? Wow. You have to clean when you come to the scripture. See? So these are the things we have to show our people, because there's a lot to us, because we are a holy people.